All right, hello everyone, and welcome to part two of the God Tree tutorial. So last time we were on the medium-sized branches, and I did a few of them for you guys, and now I have them finished. So I guess, All right, so what I was going to show you guys is this is what happens if you don't blend the branch to the tree. So, see how this barely looks like it's connected here? Now, it might not be too noticeable on just one branch, but if you do this to every branch, then it'll end up not looking good at all. So, let's go ahead and finish blending this. Alright, it doesn't really take much to blend it. You just gotta make sure it looks like it's actually coming out of the tree. Alright, so there you go. It's all blended. Alright, now I'm probably going to do the same thing with this video. I'm going to pause it for the small branches because those take a very long time. So I think I have as many medium-sized branches as I want. You don't need too many because you're going to make small branches and that's where the leaves are going to go. So, all right, let's get to it. So for small branches, it's pretty much the same deal, except you don't have to fill in like you did for these medium-sized branches. You just make sticks. All right, so let me finish. Get this little fixed up a little bit here. Alright, so basically it's the same thing. You can just go to any medium-sized branch. Just go ahead and use this one since I'm already by it. And just go to a spot that looks good, like maybe right here, and then just build off of it. And curve it around. You go up and down and around. And think of these small branches as guides for the leaves, because these are where your leaves are going to go. So these small branches, you're going to want to make sure these go out and make the tree into a circle and then up so that the tree is a good arch shape to it too. So these are probably, at least in my opinion, the way I make trees, the most important of the branches, but they're also the most tedious to make. So it can definitely get very annoying. I've had to take breaks on some of my bigger trees with these smaller branches because they just take so long. And that's definitely why I'm going to pause this video. So I guess make about 5 to 6 branches coming off of every medium-sized branch. And then you can put leaves. Actually, then we'll make the roots and then we'll put leaves on. So not too much more for this tree. Alright, let's try to go in at least somewhat of an order here. So I'll just make all the small branches for this large branch and the medium ones coming off of it. So this takes a very long time. I said that like 3 times now because it's very true. So if you don't have the patience to do this, I don't know what to tell you, because this is how I make trees, and this is why my trees look like they do. I would very highly recommend doing this, because if you don't do this, then you end up making the trees that I don't really like, where they just make these big branches, and then they just paste a bunch of leaves all over the place, and it doesn't look like it should anyway. So you know, you gotta make sure you put some branches going down. Especially with the small branches, because I know in a lot of trees, even like real life trees, none of the small branches go just up. They just go wherever the heck they want. So you just gotta go with the flow. So you know, that's enough for that branch. And then we'll do this one last branch, and then I'll pause the video and I'll make the rest of the small branches. And it's pretty much the same process for every single small branch here. You just go to the medium-sized branches, find a nice little spot here, and then just build off of it. And these small branches, you don't have to make them blend as much with the medium-sized branches, but you do want to make them blend a little bit so they don't look like they're just coming off. And you definitely want to make at least one small branch coming off of the end of the medium-sized branch, so it doesn't look like the medium-sized branch just ended. One more here, Then we'll go ahead and I'm going to go ahead and pause the video. We'll come back and make the roots. All right, I think that would be it. All right, and we're back. So, all right, so I went ahead and made the rest of these branches. So basically what I did was, or what I do for each branch once I start getting a ton of them, is I look for open spaces. So if I see an open space that's way too open, maybe like at the top or down low, like that just wouldn't look good if there wasn't any leaves there, then I add some more, like right here maybe. So see how this is pretty open over here? I just go back and then I add maybe one or two more branches. And a rule of thumb with these is that you don't want too many. So I'm going to show you a tree I made a while back, and I put a ton of branches. Like, I way overdid it. This is a tree I made like a year ago, I guess, probably. So yeah, this is what it will look like if you put a ton of, I mean, if you really want it to look like this, then by all means, you can. It doesn't look bad, but I don't really know if I like this tree, to be honest. But yeah, that's what it'll look like if you put a ton of branches. And if you keep all the branches generally straight, I guess, too. So yeah. All right, let's go back. All right. So now that we have our branches, we have enough, I think, for leaves. It'll be fine. Yeah. Not overdoing it, not underdoing it. Now we can go make our roots. So these I like to do by hand as well. So and you can do this with a little bit of voxel. So you can just make like, use a brush, skip the B, and then like a brush size of maybe 3 or 2. And then just make some, actually probably 2. 2 would probably be best. And then make, a voxel of that. And then you can just go down, do the same thing you would do with hand, and just make the root. And then go ahead and fill in. But I like to do this by hand usually, just because it looks better, in my opinion, whenever I do it by hand. So, do BB and smooth it out. Because when you do it with this, it tends to give it some odd shapes that you don't really want. You want the roots to look really like rugged almost. Yeah, fix that. Not too much here. Yeah, and it'll make them a little bit too thick in some places. So even if you do it by, or with some voxel, you're going to have to go back and do some of it by hand anyway. So I just think it's better to usually just do it by hand. So, alright, we'll just, that's one root. Alright, this is a very good place to do a root here, since it's already like halfway popping out for us. Alright, let's go about that far out, and then we're going to build it up. So I know with organics, it's generally a lot, it's pretty difficult to do them, just because you just have to have a general understanding of what things look like to be able to do organics, at least do them well, without it just being a bunch of squares or a bunch of circles, and for it to actually look natural. So yeah, that's a root by hand versus a root by voxel. Bottom tends to be a lot more thick. So I'm going to have to get rid of some of that down here. Let's fill this. Alright. And we'll do one more root right here. Generally, you don't want to do roots if you have a bend like this. You don't want to do a root right there, because then you'd have to, it would look weird and you'd have to fill in a ton. Alright, so last root here. And then after this root, I'm going to go back, make sure the tree looks generally pretty good, like everywhere else. There's no like huge thick branches or unnatural looking, occurrences on the tree. And then I'll go ahead and change the logs, and I will show you that command in a second, too. And, all right, you don't want the roots to connect too much. You do want, like, some little bit of gaps here. Sniper. All right. No, that should do the trick for that root. Let's put a little bit in the ground actually for this one, just really quick here. Alright. Now let's go back and check the tree and make sure there's no like huge ray. Oh, there we go. See, look at this. This is really big right here. I don't like that. Let's make this a little bit. Let's go 4. I'm just gonna trim this down a little bit here. Oh, I need to go by hand. Okay. I'm gonna go around here, trim it down. So this branch is way too big. Let's also cut this down in here. So yeah, you don't want the branches to be huge. That's pretty much always how that goes. Alright. So there we go. That looks a little bit better. You don't want, I don't want this branch to be that big either, right there. All right. So once it's pretty set, you've got all your branches done here. Just fix that really quick. All right. So that'll be good enough. Looks a little bit better now. All right. So now we're going to change the logs. So let's fly up here. Oh, there's somebody right there. That's my buddy Ares. That's Ares. Yeah, it's Ares. Ares and I. Speed 6. Oops. Alright, fly over here. Let's go into the ground so it changes all of the logs. There's 2. Place log 417 with 17 with 17 colon. Let's do these as, let's try this, let's see what this looks like. So basically, you can do any of the logs. So there's numbers, the 12 through 15. 12 would be regular logs. 13, oops, there's some lag here, holy moly. Let's see. Alright, there we go. So there's that. Then 13 would be the dark oak. And then 14 was the white ones I just showed you. And 15 is the jungle wood. These are just all sided logs. And then if you really want, you can do 162, which are the other two types of logs. And then there's 12, which is the gray looking ones. I forgot what they're called. So there's that. And there's 13, which are the really, really dark logs. If it changes. Oh, whoops. Alright, so if you change it to 162, you also have to change this. Forgot about that. There we go. Alright, replace it. Gotta make sure you're replacing the actual thing. Alright, so there's that. I think I kind of like this color, so we're gonna stick with this. So in that case, to change this, you would do, or to change it back from logs, the original, you would do / replace 17, or you can type log space 162 and then 13. I'm not gonna enter it because I already did it. All right, so there's that. Now let's go ahead and get the leaves going here. Let's see, what do we want for leaves? Let's go with some, I like doing this. These usually look, actually, let's just do some normal leaves. All right, so if you really want, you can look at the medium-sized tree tutorial I made, and I'd say how to make more leaves in that. So you can do 2 different colors, or even 3, and you could change the percentages that, just put down the percentages. So by percentages, I would mean, all right, so first, sorry, let's do this. Okay, / mask 0, that's obviously the first thing. You always want to make sure you do mask first. If you don't do mask first, it won't mask the right thing. So if I don't mask 0, or if I mask a different number, then it won't replace error. It will replace whatever number, that's the block ID for error. So I could also do mask error.
Alright, so then after that, dr slash was dr sphere, and then we're going to do 5% 18 colon 12, and if you do the colon 12, these are non-decaying leaves, so these are non-decaying, just regular leaves, and then comma, let's do 5%, 18, let's do 13. So I think that's, I think it's dark oak leaves, so I think it's spot, pine wood trees leaves. All right, and then you comma, 90%, 0. So you always want to make sure it equals 100%, obviously. Oh, look, there's sniper. Hello, sniper. All right, so once you've done that, I'm going to go by. I'm going to change my speed to 3. That'll be better. All right, so we're going to go by, and we're going to click on. Oops, that's way too small. Let's undo that. Forgot to put the last number there. All right, so we're going to make sure this is 5. Let's go with 5. 5 should be. It's usually big enough. Yeah, there you go. So 5, and we're going to click on all the tips of our branches. So there. Oops. There. This part takes a while, so. Yeah. All right. So let's just go quickly here. As quick as I can. And I know some servers, they don't have any numbers bigger than 5. So if you did want to do a bigger number than 5 at the end there, most servers won't let you. I know this server does. And you can do it. So, I honestly don't know any other servers that let you do that, to my knowledge. I haven't really tried it on too many servers, though, so, yeah. All right, so let's continue this. And my little, buddy flying around over there. It's not being annoying at all. And if you accidentally miss the branch and click down there, it's okay. You can just undo it. And if you make all those little holes on the ground, that's fine. Don't worry about it. It's bound to happen, especially when you're doing the smoothing out and stuff. It's gonna happen if you're doing it like you should be. So yeah, those other leaves were definitely the pine wood trees leaves. So once we've done this, if you accidentally miss a branch or two, that's okay. Don't worry about it. It'll just make it look like a real tree. I mean, not every branch has leaves on trees, so it is okay. All right. Done here. Just got them all. So as you can see, it's already starting to look pretty cool. But we don't want these leaves to look like spheres. So what we're going to do is start to fill in a little bit. So it's pretty gapped out at the moment. That doesn't look very good. You can see too much of the branches. You do want to leave it so that you can see some of the like curves and stuff you've made in the branches. It tends to look nice if you do that. So I'm going to change it to a size 6 here, just so this will go by quicker. You don't necessarily have to. You can just leave it at 5 and then fill it in here. So what I'm going to do is start to fill in a little bit here. Just make the leaves kind of connect so that they don't look like spheres. They look like leaves. So you don't want to make it too like unlogical either. Like you don't want to like go from here to like down here. With the leaves, and just that doesn't look very good. Undo 5, 6. Alright, there we go. Let's do one more. Gosh, dang, how do I click? Okay, there we go. So you want it to make logical sense in terms of like what a tree would look like. You want to connect the top branches with the top branches and lower branches with the lower ones. So like these ones, I'm not gonna like connect it with those ones up there. And then this one, I'm not gonna connect it with anything but this one right here. And basically what you're doing is just making it so all these spheres don't look like spheres anymore. And if you're doing this on a server where the leaves are decaying, if you type the colon 12 and 13, then the leaves will not decay. And if you're going to make this a download, then that's a very, even more of a important factor. So what I'm doing, as you can see, is I'm kind of going around the branches. I'm not just clicking on the branches here, like adding that. I could do that in a sense, but I don't want to do that too much because I want to leave the nice branches I have and leave like the curves so that you can see them and they look nice. If you don't like your branches, by all means, just cover them up. So, there we go. Connect this one with, connect this one with that. There we go. And all right, so we got this half of the tree pretty good there. Let's go around. Alright. So basically, once you're done with the leaves, you're pretty much done with the tree. I know I like doing the leaves the last because they're just the easiest thing. All you gotta do is click and they just make themselves. And I think it's pretty fun to do like awesome colors. And if you don't want these leaves, then you can just go back with World Edit and replace like whatever with place leaves with whatever blocks you want. It doesn't have to be the leaves I used. Could it be wool? You could even do like a cherry blossom tree kind of thing going on here. You could replace them with pink wool and white wool, or red wool and white wool, you know, whatever. You could even do like lava and water if you really wanted. I don't know how that would look, but you could do it. Might actually be kind of cool. Maybe I'll do the tree like that. It'd be interesting. Gives me an idea. There you go. Alright. So once I think these trees getting together pretty good here, just connect this over here, a little more fluff to it. So yeah, now you have a pretty big, pretty decent size god tree. If you really want to make it bigger, then by all means, you just use a bigger brush size. I think I said that in the first part. Just stair step here, you know, like that, like having. Just punch that out real quick. And if you have to go back after you've changed the logs, that's fine. Just go back and then do it and then replace those logs again. It's fine. I know I went pretty fast through this. Trust me when I say that it does take a really long time to do these trees. And I know by both these tutorials, which are pretty long tutorials in general, and I skip stuff. So, yeah. And if you guys like this, then please comment, subscribe, like it. And if you guys have any other kind of trees or any other organics in general that you want me to make, tell me and I will gladly do it for you guys. All right, I think that would conclude. Thank you guys for watching. See ya.